Hey everyone, and welcome back to episode 366 of Fallout 4. Last episode, we made it to the crater of Adam. We also cleared out this cave, just kind of talking to people. We did talk to this lady about Virgil, who is related to the main quest. Also, come here. Stand still.
Hey. You need a fix?
No, drugs are bad, okay? I'm sorry about this. Hancock, give me your clothes. I'm just going to sell this stuff to him. It's useless raider stuff, so it's nothing I'm ever going to keep with my followers.
I'll think about it.
Wrong button. It's nothing I'm ever going to keep with my settlers. We're not going to use raider power armor. Shut up and trade!
Let's see what you have.
Raider power armor is poopy, so I'm just going to sell it. But yeah, let's keep pushing west. We'll loop back. I mean, I might end up doing some main quest shenanigans here. I went way past the peril for some reason. I may do some main quest shenanigans. Wow, that's actually really nice. I mean, at least I'm with only one cap. Nice. Virgil's in a cave apparently southwest of here, so we may hit that up. We'll see. Again, this is all theft.
Hey there.
See if she has anything unique to say. I doubt it, but I'll at least try while I'm here. Okay, everybody's bald because of the radiation. Except for the mother lady over
may
there.
May Adam bless you with his glow.
Same thing. What's her name again? Mother what?
Yes?
Mother... I sold? I don't know. I don't know how to pronounce that. I wasn't paying attention enough. I didn't even hear her say her own name. But that's a weird name. Okay. This is all theft. Can I at least look in the container? Thank you. Nothing important there. Hey, buddy. Let's hug him again. I didn't even know if he just ran up the stairs. What are you doing? He's a fucking ninja. How'd he get up there? I didn't even hear him or see him, and I just walked the stairs. Did you just TP? What the hell? Okay, Ogden. That's a little scary, man. Just some random dead people here in their settlement, you know. No biggie. That's fine. Okay, I think that's the majority of the crater. So, let's do something out. Let's go up the hill, take a look around, see if we can see any enemies, and keep pushing west. Go south a bit, and we'll probably hit up the cave, I think, in the next grid. If I had to wager. Maybe, maybe not. We'll see. And again, I'm not decided. Do I want to go through there and continue the main quest? Because, I mean, I'm down here. I might. I'm thinking I will. If I find the cave that's related to this quest, I'll probably pop down in it. I don't even have our main quest marked as inactive, so I'm not getting any kind of marker. Okay. I see something over there, it looked like. Yeah, some sting wings. I think a a bloatfly right there. Beyond that, nothing much. Nope. Okay, well, let's just make sure we're going in the right direction. We are not. Right direction will be this way. It's so disorienting being here, because the map kind of is just janky. Like, I don't feel like it updates my position on it correctly. It's really weird. But let's push where the compass is telling me to go anyway and hope that this is the right way. Hey, you guys. You ready to die? That's an easy shot. Easy shot. Easy shot. Okay, who's alive? Who's alive? Hey, you. Easy peasy. Got him. He dead. Well, what's wrong with you? I say you, he did it. He did. He did. Yeah, nothing much on you. None of you guys... Oh, I just saw Hancock disappear and teleport. That was awkward. None of you guys are legendaries. I did kill the bloatfly, like, right here. The problem is... I don't think I'm going to be able to find his corpse to loot it. I always have this problem with bloatflies. There's the vampiric one, right? No, it's infected. So that bloatfly just exploded, and I don't know where his loot went. It's MIA. At least he wasn't a legendary. So at least I know I'm not losing something too good. Oh, that sucks. That happens all the freaking time. All the freaking time. They just, like, they get buried in the goop that we're, like, standing in. Is anybody down here in this pond? Puddle thing? No? Hey, what's that? That'll be for the next grid through. I suspect, but there's like a cave there. Or not a cave, but like a house. Huh. I wonder if that's in relation to Virgil? I guess that's south. Yeah, that's technically southwest. I thought they might mean more distance, but that's southwest. Okay, here's some ghouls. Now, I did just get that comic book thing. It gives me 50, well, not 50, it gives me 4 or 5% more damage or something or another. Okay, if I shoot you in the head, you die. What about a torso shot? Come on. What torso? Torso shot will kill you. Let's take it. He was the higher level one. Oh no, I missed. Oh, they're so difficult to hit sometimes. Suckers can't pathfind when I'm in the air. Glowing ones look so goofy when they were. Get him, Hancock, get him. The ghouls are just coming out of the fucking woodworks. Woodworks? The woodwork. What is going on here? Come on, ghouls, pathfind to me. I was hoping you'd just come over here and die so I could loot you all in one spot. You're gonna come running at me and scare the fuck out of me when I'm looting. Cowards, I know, right? You tell them you're a ghoul, you can tell them that they're cowards. It wouldn't be racist then, right? It's okay for you to do it. Alright. You could use a little practice? You missed. I already killed him. Alright, well, they're all dead and feels good, ma'am. Got a bowler hat here for Codsworth again. Ooh, steamer trunk. What have we in here? None of those guys were legendary. That was awkward. I encounter a lot of legendaries out here. A tux. Okay, so ammo, and you know what? You can loot
grab anything
that stuff.
Good as done.
Good as done? Well, thanks, man. Okay, so he looted that shit. That was a decent haul right there. Definitely, that's a lot of ammo. And some pre-war money. Who doesn't like pre-war money? We can sell that shit and get quite a bit of caps out of it. Oh, I don't remember looting you. No, I did not. Thought I was detected for a second. Hey, look at this. Are you seeing this? It's actually like contained to this area. A little circle. Are you seeing that? Is that supposed to be water? Like, for a second I thought it was like the gas. Like, we have gas leaks. What the hell is there water doing out here? That's weird. Well, how much do I shoot? Does it make like the explosion in water like it normally does? That is really weird. It's like water, but it's not water. Huh. Okay, then. Alright, that was a little trippy, I'm not gonna lie. there's like the radiated water, so I figured that would be radiated too. That was like pure, clean water, so that's why I kind of thought for a second it was that. Oh, really? I can't go that way. That's why for a second I thought it was the gas leak stuff. So I can't go that way at all. I'm guessing this entire mountain's gonna be off limits. Yes, sir. It does not want to let me go that way. Shocker. That's kind of what it's telling me. Alright, so that means we mark something like right here. And I try to go south into the next grid, but it keeps giving me an invisible wall and pushing me. Yeah, I'm getting fucked over here by an invisible wall big time. I'm trying to stay up top so I can use this as a good vantage point. I don't see any enemies. So this should give me the opportunity to check that little building that we saw in the mountain. Yeah, that's Hancock. Scared me for a second. I'm not as far south as I'd like to be. Okay, this fusion core is also 50%. Gotta watch that. Alright, so this should be good. Let's follow the compass again, and hopefully I don't miss that little building or whatever it was in the mountain. I'm assuming that's either Virgil or just something or another that's important. I kind of figure Virgil would be further away, but we'll see. What is marked on my map? Oh, search for tech in University Point. I was wondering what the hell that is. Is that a miscellaneous one? Yeah, I don't need that to be active. That's just putting clutter on my compass here. Is that the one that I just cleared? Something with all the ghouls, no. Oh, that's where I fought the ghouls, okay. Okay, I see where I am. And yeah, right here's the little building. Nice. Well, let's see what this building has in store for me. In before this is Virgil. It looks like a bunker. Looks like it's gonna lead to something. Ooh, hello. Decrepit factory. Yeah, it's looking industrial, alright. That's what I was thinking. Okay. Nothing's trying to kill me. That's a little bit weird. It's over here. Can I go in here? No? I saw this little thing. I thought maybe we're gonna have a bunker that I can enter into. No. Thought that was a steamer trunk for a second. That was awkward. Okay, then. Nothing? Anybody? Nobody's trying to kill me? This is weird. Sensor module. Radix, biometric scanner, right away. Hey, dead guy. Why do I feel like the sensor module is going to be important for something? Enhanced targeting card. Keep that shit. Alright, well, I don't see anything in the drawers or the little cubby holes there. I guess that's it. Huh. Now why would this be marked on the map? As a decrepit factory. If there's no Just weird. I feel like there'd be more to it. No, nothing here either. Okay. Maybe it's quest related? I don't know. But it's marked, and I looted it, so I think we're good to go. Oh, what am I seeing? Rat scorpion? 1 and 2, and I'll just go vertibird crash. I could totes take him down from here if I really wanted to. I'll probably go pop him with a pistol. Okay, well, it doesn't look like there's anything up here other than the Crater of Adam, so let's go south a bit to get in the center part of this grid. Oh god. I love flying. My power armor's too fucking much. Spacebar tapping is great. Yes. Okay, you guys. Can I see your levels from here? No? Still can't see it? Let's see if I can one-hit one of you guys with a sneak attack. Okay, there's 3 of them. You're level 30. You're level 87, and if I shoot you in the face, you don't die. Now, if I shoot you in the face with this and I crit you, you're dead. We're gonna do that. Let's solve a problem. Okay, he's right by the water. He might even fall in the water. They didn't hear it for some reason. That's weird. Well, let's build that crit back up. 1%. 9%'s pretty meh. He's gonna burrow toward me or something. Yep, instant burrow. I was listening to I wouldn't let that sting you, not even recreationally. Not even recreationally. I'm hitting.
Next one better kill me.
He walked right in front of me and I kicked his ass. Did he just deuce out a fusion core? Did he just deuce out a fusion core?
Stuff. Hey, mind if we talk now?
Did I like piss him off or something? Because like, I feel like this is about to be a speech check thingy, but I don't like the fact that he deuced out a fusion core. I'm actually confused, because that's like a perk. That's nuclear physicist. Why'd he do that? Is that something that NPCs can do? Because I don't want him to do that. I'm going to like get you out of that power armor here in a second if you can teleport to me. Okay, I'm going to wait for him. It looks like he's going to talk to us, though, for the first like stage of his dialogue. But yeah, this time I don't want to kill him. Oh shit, we got stinglings right over there, too. Okay, you're the legendary. If I kill you right here, that means you die by the plane. That's an easy way to remember where you are. Let's continue to work on those crits. Now, don't drop your fusion core this time, please. That's just awkward. I want to build my crit back up off of this rat scorpion real fast. Hey, buddy. That's a real 69%. Why is this percentage so meh? Why'd you dig over there? You just dug further away from me. Get closer, come on. These rat scorpions are so weird. He just dug up directly underneath me. What a dick. I hate these rat scorpions. Shut up and die. Get out of here. Give me my crits. Yay, I get my AP back. Wouldn't let it sting you even recreationally? Yeah, I wouldn't want to be stung recreationally either.
Mind if we talk now?
Yeah, as long as you don't eject your fusion core.
Is everything alright?
Yeah, it ain't anything bad. Just you taking care of Bobby. I ain't proud of having to put you through that. That sort of dictatorial shit ain't usually my style.
You seem awfully torn up over Bobby. Was there something between you?
Nah, nothing like that. I just hate seeing guys like me use their sway to do that kind of harm. Hell, that sort of bulls the whole reason I became mayor in the first place. Some ass named Vic ran the town for I don't know how long before that. Guy was scum. Used us drifters like his own personal piggy bank. He had this goon squad he'd use to keep people in line. Every so often he'd let them off the leash, go blow off some steam on the populace at large. Folks with homes could lock their doors, but us drifters, we got it bad. There was one night, some drifter said something to them. They cracked him open like a can of cram on the pavement. We all just stood there, did nothing.
Was there no one who could have helped?
Who knows? Maybe. Honestly, we were all so terrified we couldn't bring ourselves to move until it was over, let alone get help. I felt like less than nothing. Afterwards, I got so high, I blacked out completely. When I finally came to, I was on the floor of the old state house, right in front of the clothes of John Hancock. John Hancock. First American hoodlum and defender of the people. I might have still been high, but those clothes spoke to me. Told me what I needed to do. I smashed the case, put him on, started a new life as Hancock. After that, I went clean for a bit, got organized, convinced Cleo to loan me some hardware, got a crew of drifters together and headed out into the ruins, started training. Next time Vic's boys went on their tear, we'd be ready for them.
You don't actually think the clothes of John Hancock spoke to you, right?
Nah, I just felt, you know, a connection. It seemed like he and I were dealing with the same shit. Serious oppression. So, the night of, we all got loaded. Let Vic's boys get good and hammered. And burst from the windows and rooftops where we'd been hiding. They never even saw it coming. We didn't have to fire a shot. We didn't have to. But we sure fucking did. It was a massacre. Once we'd mopped up, we strolled right into Vic's quarters in the state house, wrapped a rope around his neck, and threw him off the balcony. And there I am, gun in hand, draped in Hancock's duds, looking at all the people of Good Neighbor assembled below. I had to say something. That first time I said them, they didn't even feel like my words. Of the people, for the people, was my inaugural address. Became Mayor Hancock of Good Neighbor that day. And from then on, I vowed I'd never stand by and watch. Ever again.
You fought so hard to become mayor. Why leave?
I ain't really the ponderous type. When an instinct takes hold, I listen. This time around, instinct said I should join up with you. Seems it was a good one. I just hope you get where I was coming from. I ain't out to bring harm to anyone that didn't earn it. Though I'm getting the distinct idea, you got the same plan. Well, you probably heard enough of me running my mouth for one day. Wanna get moving?
Oh god. Oh god. Wait, way to cut our dialogue short, you dumb rat scorpion. Oh, that was awkward, but...
Oh. Someone needs help, we help them. If someone needs hurt,
okay. So, there's some of Hancock's dialogue. At least we know we're doing it right, and... We're progressing with them already pretty quickly, I might add. Where's this rat scorpion right here? That was a pretty cool story of his. Irritated, was it irradiated, agitated, improved, automatic what? Laser pistol. Does 50 points additional radiation damage. That's actually not bad. 50 points on each shot, and this is an automatic. Of course, you can make it a single shot, but that's kind of cool. I'll take everything. Should be able to carry it. Cool. There's also these dudes back here. Which are kind of, sort of, not in the grid, but I'm going to go knock them out. Also, we were mildly dehydrated during the discussion with them. Like, it was like, you are starving. You are dying of thirst. Eat something and drink something. So, I'll just take care of that real quick. That was cool. Backstory on Hancock. I do have to watch my health, though. My rads are actually really fucking high. I've been in here for a while. That is a level 80 fucking 7. Oh, I need to build the crit, so I need to hit him with bats. Come here, man. Come here. Come on. Come on. Come on. That's a shitty chance. I don't like that chance. Can I get a better chance than that, please? He's gonna hit me. Okay. Push him away. Push him away. Nice. Explosive damage was actually hurting me. Missed me. I feel ill insomnia. Damn. I don't need to hit him with this. I can just kill him. Get him, Hancock.
Gonna bother us again.
Okay, so
I... As old as it looks?
Yes, it's as old as it looks. I have to use some antibiotics here. Nice, which means we're now thirsty again. And I don't have that much purified water on me, to be honest with you. But we're back to being hydrated, so that's decent. Alright, I don't need to be going this way too much. I kind of just wanted to kill them because they were right next to my crib. Now, let's resume exploring. Yes. And I level up again, so I have 2 points to use. I could put some points in the Demolition Expert right now if I want. Decisions. Like the whole Crit Banker thing, and working on that tree. And the Demolition Expert's going to work all the time. And it's going to, if I get the Psycho one, it's going to give me the arc on my grenade, which would be pretty decent. That's going to be nice, actually. I kind of look forward to that one. I'm curious to see how they implemented it. I've seen it like in other games, but I've never seen that actually in Fallout. I'm curious to see what that looks like. Is that a Deathclaw I'm seeing over there? Yes, it is. Don't run from me. Don't run from me. Shit. Is that another Deathclaw? Hold on. This isn't within the grid, but there's two friggin' Deathclaws staring me down. I'm gonna kill them. Is that a Deathclaw right there? What's right there? That's definitely two Deathclaws. We got a mama Deathclaw and a daddy Deathclaw? What's going on here? Because they're gonna die. They're gonna die real good. That's an alpha Deathclaw. He's only level 31, though. Poor guy. Okay, let's pop him in the face.
I got something.
Okay, he did. Does that mean the other one's mama Deathclaw? Albino Deathclaw, level 71. Right in the belly. Get bloody messed. Sneak attack and a belly shot, which is our weak spot. And then he chunked. That was perfect. I'm sorry, Albino Deathclaw, but you did. You did in a big kind of way. Oh, God. 25% of the fusion core. I got my warning. Rip this Deathclaw. You didn't have a chance. You didn't even know what hit you. Poor guy. All right. That worked out really fucking well. Okay. I need to go north a bit. We're a little further south than I think I need to. But the Deathclaw made it worth it. For damn sure. I'm sorry, buddy. I'm sorry, Alpha Deathclaw and Albino Deathclaw. You guys didn't deserve it. Okay, you kind of sort of did. I mean, I guess they really didn't. But they're Deathclaws, so they deserve it anyway, because I have to kill them. That's just what you do with Deathclaws. Really? Nope, nothing here? I'm not seeing any enemies. This huge little, like, power station thing that's submerged in radiated water. There's no enemies trying to kill me here. That's not awkward or anything. I don't believe this. I don't believe this at all. For real? Okay. This seems weird. I'm expecting something to try to kill me in every twist and turn. Is that so wrong? I think it's like... I think it's okay to assume. Is this that Deathclaw that I killed earlier? Yeah, this is the Deathclaw that I killed earlier. I don't remember being that far south when I killed him, but it could also just be the map playing tricks on me because of the way the map works and... Because it's not, let me check the map, like, for example, you can't go, like, right here. I could only start going south until, like, somewhere over here, so it's, like, slanted, and I feel like the map and the compass, there's, like, some disorientation going on there, but whatever. Okay, we got a level 30 and a level 22. If I can pop the level 30 in the tummy, kill it. Okay, it's almost dead. Okay, it's dead. Okay, both dead died in the same spot. It makes it easy to loot them. But yeah, I feel like the map and the compass, they're disoriented a bit. So it kind of plays tricks with me. So you were an alpha Deathclaw, and you were what, a regular one? Regular Deathclaw. I figured it was a matter of time. It was only a matter of time until I finally got over-encumbered, because I have so many Deathclaw hands and so much Deathclaw hide and meat, and that stuff's heavy as shit. I'm surprised it took me that long to get over-encumbered, to be honest with you. Here you go, Hancock. Look at this.
See if he had anything worth taking.
You got it.
I do got it.
Grab anything.
Now you have it.
Good. Take anything good.
Did you get it all? Okay, you already got it. That's right, your inventory's pretty empty. Okay. And our inventories are both doing pretty well. If his inventory's just now starting to get filled up, because I sold all the stuff that he had, because we were at the vendor. And this is a ghoul that I killed because I remember this tree. So yeah, this is the thing playing with me. Like, the map's kind of fucking with me here. How many do we got? Two? Okay, both relatively low level. Pop you. Where are you gonna TP to? Where are you gonna TP to? Yeah, I just saw you burrow over there. It's a little weird. Get away from me. Nice try. I love using the power armor to escape them. O'Neill Family Manufacturing. Okay. Ooh, we can just go straight down into the place. This is gonna be intriguing. And it's definitely a little bit further south than the grid, but let me investigate it. And we are also very much detected. What's here? What's nearby? I don't see anything, but it could be inside the building. Whatever it is. Yeah, it must be inside the building. Okay. Okay, which way do we want to go? Up top? This is locked. That is locked. I am assuming we're going to go down and loop around and come out the top. If I had to guess. That's my guess. What have we in here? Ooh, cool. Oh. Try taking that pot shot because we weren't detected.
I didn't say we were finished.
I didn't say we were finished either, but I hit him. Oh, here he comes. I can hear him. Yep. Just sprayed him all over the damn wall. Rip. Alright, hold on. Hold your horses, Hancock. We need to explore this lair before we go to the next floor. Calm down. Okay, no tarps, no real loot or anything like that in here. Nothing there. Okay, so that's actually all that this layer, this level has to provide, it looks like. Not a lot. I'll take some brain fungus. Charred ghouls, they look so goofy. Every time I see them. The withered ghouls too, when they run, it's hilarious. Some drugs for Hancock, you know he's hyped about that. Excuse me. We're not even detected in the slightest. Is there nothing else in here? Seems awkward to me. Nothing in that. Alright. What are we gonna find in here? Can I loot you? I can totes loot you through the wall. Careful. Feels good.
You don't know where that's been.
It's been in this container for probably a really long time. I think I have an accurate guess as to where it's been. Nice, power armor station. I could repair my power armor, doesn't really need it. And I also would have to have the mats in my inventory, but I'm sure I could repair something. I'm not going to worry about it, though. It's kind of cool, though, that there's one here. Ammo? I bet this is going to unlock that door up top. Sentry bot model kit. Yay, sentry bot. Yay, sentry bot model. Sentry bot model build kit. Oh, yeah. And let's hit up this terminal. What have we in here? Open roof access door. Let's see the invoices first. William Thomas. Customer William Thomas. Problem. Mr. Handomly. I like combined Mr. Handy and randomly. Mr. Handomly. Nice. Mr. Handy randomly loses mobility and falls to the ground about 4 times a day. Asked if he knew what could have caused the issue. Will reported. I thought it was like Will, lowercase. Will reported seeing the neighborhood kids throwing baseballs at the robot. However, no physical damage noticed upon inspection. Labor, 16 hours. Mechanic report. Although no physical harm was noticed, one of the guys did find some loose screws inside. Upon further inspection, it was determined that the propulsion fail switch, which was being activated by one or more of the loose screws, I'm having a terrible time reading right now. Upon further inspection, it was determined that the propulsion fail switch was being activated by one or more of the loose screws causing the Mr. Handy to fall to the ground. Causing the Mr. Handy. Jerod Bean, I'm guessing. Or Jared. Jared Bean. Let's go with Jared. Jared. Jared brought his Mr. Handy, air quotes, after noticing it constantly bumping into things around the house. Labor, 8 hours. Mechanic report. 2 of the 3 optical sensors have been wired incorrectly, causing the bot to mistranslate incoming data on its surroundings. This bot has been so heavily modified, I'm sure it's breaking all kinds of federal laws. Jessica McCann. Problem. Jessica brought in her company's Protectron after several coworkers complained of a mildew smell coming from the bot. When asked about any potential causes, Jessica reported that the company did host a happy hour last week and things may have gotten a little out of control. Oh god. The Protectron may or may not have been involved in a pool party. Labor, 4 hours. Mechanic report. The lower compartment was completely filled with water, drained, cleaned, rinsed, and dried. Well, that was an easy fix at least. And let's open the door. Communication link established. Roof access security lock released. Opening door. I don't really hear the door or anything like that. Maybe if there's a death call, it jumps out at me as soon as I open or go to the door. Or we're detected. So something was triggered. Or a bunch of ghouls were let out. I'm just listening. Because we're really close to being detected. Kind of feels like something's going to pathfind to me and try and eat my face off. What's up here? We'll have to figure it out next episode, guys, because it's time to wrap it up. Sorry. Wrap it up here, guys. Episode 366 of Fallout 4. So, the decrepit factory, we finish up the Crater of Adam. We hit, like, a dead end over here. Started working our way back. O'Neill Family Manufacturing. We'll see what's going on with the hubbub is upstairs. Probably go to Somerville, drop some things off. Hey, we got a new settler after we get back over here. And I guess I'll continue exploring this. So we'll probably be finding Virgil here soon. He's related to the quest. So, good stuff. Thank you guys all for watching. And I'll see you next time.